Every AI company seems to be exploding right now. And part of that, it really depends on the infrastructure and the foundation that runs AI. And data centers are becoming the real winners of the AI boom. So one of the top players to watch right now is APLD. This is the company that focuses on data center infrastructure, and they've seen a surge recently similar to the AI boom. And we're actually going to be traveling a lot this week too. So we'll still be live every day at Market Open, regardless of travel. So if you ever want to be alongside us, see how we analyze stocks like APLD, our daily live trading sessions, tune on in at Market Open tomorrow morning. It's a second link in the description below. And you get a free t-shirt when you join. So APLD is going to be one of the top companies that we've seen recently. And we see this very consistent uptrend throughout from $13 a share up to $28 a share. And if we really look at why they've surged so much, it's partly because of things like ChatGPT and Grok and, Gemini and all the things that go into the AI demand. And if we look at their company, they're specifically building data centers for big tech, a lot of hyperscalers, and they are focused on finding cooling solutions through not just liquid cooling, but by building data centers in very cold places. So they're building in North Dakota, you know, going to the coldest places on earth to build the data centers basically increases the efficiency. There's even some talk from, I don't know if it was like Bezos or someone else, who were saying the next level of data centers are going to be launched into space so that cooling costs keep things really efficient or something like that. And then they also strategically place near renewable energy sources. So you could see that they are choosing whether it's solar power, wind power, that's big in North Dakota where they're building, and that they have constructed about 480 megawatts in the last 18 months, and they have about 1.4 gigawatts in future site pipelines. And that includes a deal with CoreWeave that's about $11 billion, and their market cap's still only around, I think it's $5 to $6 billion. And Supermicro Computer, who does all the racking systems, Intel, you got Dell Technologies, NVIDIA is a partner there. So they're building these data centers. Now, the markets of AI infrastructure is seeing so much demand that there's almost no space in between or let up on the actual business growth. It's very much, you know, every single company is looking to build data centers, and they're seeing the demand kick in. And so they've seen their stock also start to surge. Now, when we look at the history of APLD, kind of take a step back, we've seen them make runs up into $34 a share before, back in 2021. And then they kind of sizzled out, and have been slowly building their market cap before recently surging from April with the greater market up into 28 bucks. So now that they're at this level of resistance, can they continue? Well, here is why the financials are a really key thing to look at, because if they're signing deals that are, again, $11 billion with CoreWeave and then another $3 billion with another company for building data centers, and their market cap's currently at $7 billion, that would lead us to believe that they're undervalued at the moment and that they're going to receive more than the current market cap in compensation for the value they're bringing to the marketplace of AI. So when you look at the revenue, they have seen increases year over year and just a little bit of a drop off though in the last two quarters. So this is really key, because while their balance sheet has gone up to $1.8 billion, which is a pretty big chunk of that market cap they have, about $7 billion. So they're still just on the surface before we see the income reported from these data center deals looking overvalued at the moment, but factoring in the deals they've announced over the last few months, that they still would be considered undervalued and potentially could have another 20 to 40% upside if those deals fully materialize. Now, what we know about the deals is that they are signed, and that they are approximately 15-year terms, and Applied Digital anticipates generating approximately, it was $7 billion back then, and this was in June, and then they upgraded that to $11 billion in August. And so if that's the case, we should watch closely. I just was over in StockMate this morning as we, you know, every day we have our daily live trading sessions, as I mentioned, but we also have the different earnings that are coming out. And I just popped in and I see this Thursday after hours, they're going to be reporting their earnings. So if their earnings come in this week with anything over $50 million in the quarter, they're going to be probably seeing some really good positive feedback from the market. So really key week. The other thing to watch is while other companies that are working, let's say, in defense right now in the tech space might see a little bit of a impact from the government shutdown, and that they might not see as many contracts while the government is shut down. There's zero contracts actually while the government shut down. And so when we look at the recent moves on APLD, they're not government, they're a company working with the biggest tech companies in the world. They could continue to see some growth even through the government shutdown. And that's why a lot of tech, really, we haven't seen any negative impact from this government shutdown. In fact, when we were jumping in to the analysis, for example, on Mercatus, which is our AI app, you can search basically any of your favorite, you can search your favorite models. So what we're going with Grok right now, for example, and we now have it going through the press releases, going through all the data sources like the SEC filings. It's going through the financials. And at this moment, we're about to get some projections for APLD here. So there we go. We got some projections from the AI. And we can also drop in this government shutdown here. So the government shutdown data is something we're considering. Now, some people get really scared around government shutdowns. They say, oh, here we go, government shutdown, watch out. But really, when we look at the history, this is data that's not always easily found. We're able to plug this into the AIs. And as you can see, with the exception of defense, usually there's very low impact on technology. In fact, companies in the S&P 500, so the general stock market, has averaged actually 12.7% of gains during government shutdowns. So why is that key? Well, when we look at, for example, all of the shutdowns in the past, and you can kind of see the market returns just dating back, all this data is considered by the AI. It's really good to know that because there's certain instances that fuel the market in certain directions based on sentiment. And sentiment for this company is that in the next 3 months, potentially, we could see them push up to as high as $29 a share. And the next year, projections based on what we've seen from the factors considered by the AI here at Grok is projecting APLD to potentially surge as high as $33, 25% from here. So I don't know how the next day looks like. So it's timing a correction. And that's kind of what I was actually expecting, was a potential correction over the next day. Looks like it's bullish over the next week, because as you can see, it just reached a high. It surged. It was peaking out here at $28. It just sold down to a previous resistance, which oftentimes previous resistance will act as a support level. We see it bounce that support level right here. And maybe this is the run it's going to make, continuing up into that $29 or $30 range. About a 14% swing is possible. I have long-term positions, so I'm going to continue to hold and actually look for even a pullback on the stock, potentially, again, back down into this level, maybe into that $24 or $25 range. I think that would be really attractive for a shorter-term trade. In the long-term, though, not really doing much, expecting some volatility. We might see a big sell-down tomorrow. Maybe we see a big push-up, but expecting some short-term volatility as the tech market has been fairly volatile. So when we're looking at the short term, again, the nearest support level is at $25 a share, maybe $25.20, somewhere in here. And the nearest resistance is going to be up there again, around $28, about 5% increase. So it's currently, you know, if you're looking at a trade, you know, having those levels in mind would be helpful and definitely seeing a nice support level at 2520 on Friday to watch into this week. So when it comes to APLD, the energy sector is big. And when we look at where they're building the data centers and going directly to the point of generation, that puts us in a position to see that they're not just a regular data center company. They're not just building these anywhere. In fact, I don't know about some of these companies that are building data centers over in Phoenix or places that get really hot in the summer. To me, that's just waiting for a blackout, basically. Like, it gets so hot in those places. So when I see them, you know, sign these deals and they're, maybe it's not the most pretty, like no offense to anybody in North Dakota, it can be very pretty, but how much do you have going on out there? Is there big tech hubs out there? Probably not too much, like mostly farmland. It's beautiful, but it's fairly frigid and cold in the winters, you know, which can be nice for some people. But when I'm looking at this building out in North Dakota, there's no other reason other than the frigid temperatures and the very cheap real estate and power for them to do so. And while, you know, you might say, well, wow, seems like they're doing everything to squeeze every little bit out of having a good data center. That's probably what they need to be able to do these massive deals and for them to make the deals make sense. And so it seems like they're on the right track. We're going to continue to hold our long-term positions, keep you guys updated on the news and events or anything that comes out, as we haven't seen any news in the last week or two. But we'll be watching again in StockMate's are after hours Thursday. They are reporting earnings, so that's a big day on Thursday. I'll be just arriving or leaving actually on a flight out to Argentina, so it'll be a busy week. But hey, I appreciate you all. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. If you want to join us to see these opportunities at market open tomorrow, it's the second link in the description below. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.